And now, a brief intermission for some mischief. Guys, and welcome back to episode 6 of Oceancraft. Things might look a little bit different into the base to how they look in the episode. I've had to record this bit afterwards because I decided to split the episodes. So let's jump back right in now, where I am over at Rick's base over in this direction over here. I don't want to show you too much, but Rick's base is over in that direction. So let's meet him over there. I've got him on a voice call and we'll see what we get up to. All right, this is easier. These villages, I'm going to have to turn my sounds down now. music and sounds. Well, that's so much better. That's so much more peaceful. Well, I tell you what, with the mending, but we're going to be rich.
Yeah, we might need to change the shop now. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I don't know. Just start with one and then secretly sneak it in.
Yeah, that's right.
I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I've got 11 silk touch books on me. How have you done?
Not too good. I've got only 2 books. I've got only enough emeralds for 2 books, actually.
I've got 5 more emeralds if you want another one. Do you need some books as well?
Yeah, I definitely need some books. I didn't have any letters, so I couldn't make any.
Yeah, there you go. I've got tons and tons in my base. Obviously, I've just raided loads and loads from the stronghold.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I think I've got about 4 or 5 stacks. And I've got loads of leather as well. I went on a I was trying to get some cow heads. I don't think I've got one yet, actually, but
I actually got a decent amount of leather at the start, but yeah, you use it for a lot, actually, so it goes away quickly.
Right, what's he got? Oh, good, we've got mending for 24.
Oh, 2 just, mending for villages now.
Yeah, yeah, oh. I've just unlocked this guy with 24. Yeah, cool.
Oh, no, look behind you. There's like 6 more.
Oh, right, I'm going to go and hide
okay,
in the
Okay, time to go inside.
Yeah. Time to hide in the portal.
Oh.
No! Right, guys, I think by now you've probably worked out exactly what we're doing. But me and Rick Jev, we decided, you've seen, obviously, he's got a villager breeder. So what we have decided to do is we're going to work together. I had this idea that I was well, I said I was going to help him with sort of organizing the villagers, trying to sort them out into types and locking them and that sort of thing. Came across, obviously, had a really good silk touch villager, and we found a couple of mending villagers, as you saw in some of those earlier clips. So what we've decided to do is we're going to open a silk touch, and then we're going to put some mending books in the shop, and we've decided to build it in the style of a diamond block, which you can see in super speed here. So yeah, it's a good project that we're working together on, or decided to work together on. It came completely out of the blue. We just sent him a message, obviously, because he's so close to the base. You know, I just asked him if it was going to be all right that I'd borrow some of his villagers for this, and it's really good. So we've got some silk touch, we've got some mending, and then we decided I think we're going to sell some of the silk touch things in there as well. So obviously you've got podsil blocks, you've got grass blocks, that sort of thing. So yeah, so that's what we're going to sell in this shop. But that is pretty much what we are doing here. They've not got much to say, obviously. I've dubbed this over afterwards, so I'm going to let you get back to enjoying this video and this music, available on YouTube Audio Library. It's called Spanish Rose, actually. It's a lovely, lovely tune. So enjoy. Yeah, that looks all right. People know it's a diamond block.
I mean, hope
it's,
so.
It's not anything else.
No. No, I think they'll get it.
Cool. I'm quite happy with that. What's it look like from above? I've got a...
It actually looks kind of nice from the inside as well.
Yeah. I've got a second account that they've authorized as a camera account, so I could have a fly around and have a see what it looks like.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, maybe you can help me with my slime farm then, because I want to light up the caves that are around it.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, I'm sort of on the fence about using it for cheaty things like that.
Oh, yeah, I understand.
Because it's sort of like... No, but it's weird, like, because it's easy to just put the seed in and into a single player world and just fly around and find all the spawners and stuff.
Yeah, true.
Which is fine, but like using it for something, I don't know. But
yeah, no, it's all right.
But it would help it would massively help the rates though. Right, so this is obviously a bit of a cutty episode. I did promise myself I was going to try and keep this within a reasonable amount of time. But then, as you have just seen in the previous clips then, there has been a decent bit of building sort of in between as well. So we met up with our neighbour, who I'm going to call, I think it's Reekjev, right, Jev? Something like that. He lives just out to the east of us in the jungle, and he's been breeding up some villagers, and I agreed to sort of help him organise them and sort them out and stuff and unlock the trades, which is going to be something that I'm going to work on in between episodes, but I will show you it as we move along with it. But what's quite cool is we picked up a silk touch villager for not a bad price, and we actually have two mending villagers as well, so that's pretty sweet. So what we've done, we built a little shop, as you saw. I'm not sure how much of the clips I'm going to actually pop in, because obviously we were just sort of chatting and playing. I wasn't really trying to record an episode at that point. We were just sort of building and chatting. So you've seen bits and bobs. It's gone pretty well so far. We've sold 3 silk touch books last time I checked, and this morning I put on a little notification saying that we can take pre-orders for mending books, and we've already sold 2, so we need to get them and get them delivered. I said I was going to deliver them in between the episodes. So this is our wonderful shop. But we need to get stocked up with amending as soon as possible, because over there, hiding over there behind the Enderman, we've got a chap called Anderson there, just where the crafting bench is over there in the distance. He's also opening a mending shop. So that's good. And I completely forgot to bring some glass. I've pretty much finished this, but I haven't done it yet. So first things first, I brought some stuff with me. Because this person here, who is called Tini Bazinga, and she is, yeah. do you have an ender chest? All right, guys. So we are back. I'm sort of in the middle of building. This is going to be a bit of a cutty one, really, in between. So what I am doing at the moment is I'm just building what is going to be the targets. I'm not sure how tall I want this to be, but I've got some blocks in this chest. So I've got some podzol, I've got some coarse dirt, normal dirt. I've got a bit of acacia, which we're going to have dotted around, then some cobble, gravel, and a side bits and bobs, just to sort of texturize it. So it's going to be quite a rough... fizzy drinks. So it's going to be quite a rough area. But what we are going to use for the targets is these, and obviously I appreciate right now these don't look too targety, but if you look at this magic carrot on a stick, you'll see magic happening. And what this actually is it's a data pack, and it's supposed to be a... what's the word I'm looking for? It's supposed to be a wrench. It's a wrench that was added by the data pack. I haven't got the texture on there, so I think that is the best way to have it. Yeah, that's the target. So let's get all them in position. So these are going to be the targets. And then I'm going to make a giant arrow. Oh, that's off. Needs to move. That is going to need to move. Right. So that is going to have to go there. Doot, doot. Boom, boom. So this is going to be an archery range. Or the idea is it's going to look like an archery range, but people can use it if they like. But the idea is it's going to be a... obviously a bow shop. So behind it, I'm going to build a giant bow, or maybe alongside it somewhere. Coming up here, or maybe behind there. I'm not entirely sure, but I've got a plan for that. Which we'll do at some point in the future. But so that's the plan. So I'm going to sort of... I think it's going to be quite an open building. It's just going to be a couple of chests in the middle, and then I'm going to just sort of surround it with these. So I might need to go out into the ocean a little bit. I don't want to go out too far. Oops. Let's not do this for a second time. But yeah, I'm going to make a little bit more progress on this, guys, and I will pull you back once I've got a better idea of what I'm planning on doing here. All right, so I've sort of stretched it out back a little bit here. I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do here. What I might do is have these up a little bit higher. So these are basically, obviously, there's three targets. So I think the idea is this is going to be like, each one's going to be like a little row. Maybe we have... this come up here, and then it's like a full row. So everybody's got their own designated range. So that should be that'd be pretty good. Where have we got some more acacia in here? Right, sorry, messages. Let's get some of this bit built as well. And so we need a couple of sticks. I'm going to need some more fences. Woo, diamonds! So we sold some stuff for 10 diamonds, so that's cool. So that is good. So let's dump this in. Yeah, I think that's quite a nice way of having it, because then if we have this come up over... the phantoms have returned. Yeah, if we have this come up here, then we can have this come over here. We might have to have a brief intermission for phantom killing. Right, so we've got a little bit more building done. The Phantom Danger's over. So I'm just sort of going around now, because we've got obviously grass in some places. So what I want to do now is I want to sort of texturize the area a little bit. Because it looks quite nice. Obviously, there's going to be... This area, I think, needs to be a bit more beaten up, because there's going to be more people having sort of wandered around here. And then we can have, obviously, this bit in the entrance there as well. And then it's going to be sort of slightly less worn, I would say, as you go down to the bottom here. But I don't know what to do sort of around there. I don't know whether we should put some like directly there. That'd be quite cool. But then obviously we could have some stuff in here. But I feel like this doesn't need to be as fenced off as it is. So I'm thinking maybe we could... I don't know, because I feel like this could be wider, but I don't want it to block this shop and I don't want it to be too wide as well. So maybe these fences are just going to have to stay like this. And I suppose if we use them as the basis for building the bow off as well, then that'd be quite cool. So let's just jump in here with a couple of the blocks that we've got. Gravel as well. Cool. Maybe put a little bit of gravel in there. Coarse dirt. Dump that back there. And then maybe a gravel there, podsel in there, and some coarse dirt. Where did the coarse dirt go? Nothing quite like the bugs. Yeah, so we'll put a coarse dirt in there. Maybe we'll put a cobble and podsel in there. Yeah, and the idea is you just want to make it look a little bit worn, and I think this is going to look quite cool, really. So that. I quite like what the podsel does for it, really. Maybe we'll put that there and there. How does that look? I think we're looking nice and random is the name of the game. I think that is probably about right. So... next thing is we need a couple of chests over here. So let's go. So we just need 4, I would say, would be enough. But actually, what I might do is I might make a... No, that'll do. So we want chests going here and then an exact mirror copy on that side. We need a couple of signs. So that will do on top of this one. So we need... so these ones are going to be... the mending bows. These ones are going to be... infinity bows. And then we're going to have a bargain basement section. I don't know where to put the bargain basement one. We'll put it there. And then we'll have a bargain bin. So anything that's got like Curse of Vanishing or anything like that, that can go in that one. But to be fair, this is pretty much it. All we need to do now is pick up some wood, because I want to go and build a giant arrow there. So let's... I think pretty much all we need to do now here is bone meal the area a touch just to get some grass. And what I want to do for some lighting... I think would be quite cool would be to be nice if we could get some flowers. So I might have to bring some flowers with me as well. But yeah, but I think that's looking pretty good, really, for but that is my inventory completely full, so I think I might have to dump some junk in there, and we'll take it home. I wonder if any of this could go in a shop. So that shop stock, that shop stock, that could be shop stock. That doesn't matter, that can stay here for now. Cool. So I'm going to dump some stuff in the shop. I'm going to go and get some stuff for making the bow. Then we'll be back. I'll pull you back when I am back here with some more stuff. Right, we're back. I've got some stuff in hand. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to build the bow out of this. This, we're going to need a little bit of that. And I've lost my stone. Oh, it's in my fund. That'd be why. Cool. Now, the bow design is 15 wide. This is 10. So I reckon if we go... Well, if we go out to either side, obviously that's 14. So I think if we start... So that'd be 1, 2. So if I start this 3 out, so 1, 2, 3. And then pop the first block there. And then it's going to be one, and then it goes out to the side there, and it goes one, two, three, four, and then it goes there, and then there, and two, three, and then it goes there. I'm going the wrong direction. Dragon. Right, so that goes there. And then, if I wasn't being an idiot, I'm going to need to pop that there. So this goes up 4, 2, 3. Yeah. And then that goes there. So then we go out 1, 1, 2. So that's 3. And then we go 1 there. And then we go... then it is stone... Stone, 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 stone. So you make a cross, and then you effectively then treat this one as the bottom of another cross. So it's that. I can't remember. I'm confused. Let's have a see how we're doing. So it should be 1, 2, and a peak there as well. We need another cross there. That should be right. That looks right. And then when you get to here, you have a spruce log there. And then it is 1, 2, 3. And then you go up one and then go 1, 2, 3, 4. Up one. That is the end. And that should be perfect. So, I should be able to just build this, cover this up, and then we'll go across and put the things in. So yeah, I'll show you what it's like when I've got it a bit more complete. Yes, free obsidian! See if he needs a bow. We'll pay him in bows. Cool. Right, so anyway, so that's the train. So that is the thing. I wonder if it's... It looks like it's kind of off-center. Have I built this wrong? Yeah, I wonder whether this should have gone across a little bit further then. Because this looks like it's... Well, it looks like it's sort of stuck there, but it also looks like it's not in the right place. I think what I'm going to do, and I'm going to pull this down, I'm going to pull it up a little bit and then move it along there as well. So, I'm going to pull this down and I will pull you guys and I will show you the finished product. All right, guys. So this is the finished build. So the idea is, obviously, it looks a lot more like that than it needs to, but that is the bow in the right position. So I think it's quite nice. It adds onto the thing a bit. What I'm going to do, I think, in between the episodes, I've got a little bit of spruce leaves and I've got some glowstone with me as well. So I think what I might do is sort of... I don't know whether this is going to work so much or whether... Um, whether that's going to help to sort of add light around the place. But yeah, so I'm going to just sort of put a few of these around for lighting so I can get rid of some of these torches. And then, yeah, I think that's going to be it for this episode, guys. So I know it's been a bit all over the place, and it's been recorded over 3 separate days. That is because I'm moving house this weekend, and I was determined to try and get a video done and out for you. So this should come out on Saturday, hopefully. It might be late on Saturday, it'll be after Minecon, I expect. So yeah, that'd be cool. And then in the next episode, guys, I will have a chat with you about what we found out about Minecon, see which biome was voted that we were going to be, that they're going to be updating next. But until then, guys, thank you very much for watching. If you did enjoy the video, I would love it if you could leave a like. And if you haven't already, please do consider subscribing to the channel. It really does help it out. And it will also keep you up to date with more Oceancraft videos. And also, with any... with some other series that we've got going on as well. So there is Survival. And we've also got... some Minecraft stories which we are coming up with as well. So thank you very much for watching, guys, if you did enjoy it. And that is it for next time. See you later.